Thank you, President. Pursuant to Standing Order 23.29, I lay on the table the final report from the Environment and Planning Committee on the inquiry into recycling and waste management, including appendices, extracts of proceeding and minority reports. I further present transcript of evidence, and I move that the transcript of evidence lie on the table and the report be published.
The question is that the transcripts of evidence lie on the table and the report do be published. Those out of opinion say aye. Against no. I believe the ayes have it. Mr. Mellon.
President, I move that the Council take note of the report, and in doing so, I'd like to say a few words. This has been a very complex and important inquiry, and can be seen from the more than 700 submissions. The issue of recycling and waste management is one of matters to Victorians. During the course of the inquiry, the committee held 14 days of public hearings, hearings from 135 witnesses in addition to the submissions, and has input from recycling and waste management industry, state and local government agencies and authorities, environmental group and industry bodies, as well as individual committee members and community groups. In this report, the committee made 33 findings, as well as 46 recommendations on a range of issues. The committee has provided an overview of the Victorian recycling waste management system, including some descriptions of the cause and effect of what has become known as the recycling crisis. In addition, the committee has considered a number of issues, including the need to reduce waste, and particularly sending waste to landfill, and with all the environmental and public health and amenity problems landfill generate. The inquiry heard about a number of issues that impact on landfill, including Victoria Waste Levy is lowest in Australia, and to provide no disincentive to send material to landfill and send material transferred to Victorian landfills from states with a high landfill, New South Wales $141 versus Victoria $64. And long-term as well as short-term cost to landfill, particularly to local government. The impact of food organic and garden organic on landfill, 40% of the waste municipal landfill bin is organic waste and causes leaches in landfill and is a contributor to greenhouse gases, including methane. The committee heard from a number of solutions, including to available to reduce the amount of material going to landfill, including increasing the landfill levy, better separation of recycling material, the establishment of energy from waste options, and the need for investment in developing market for recycled material, including through government procurement policies. The issue of contamination of recycling material was a key issue and has affected not only the capacity of export recyclable material, but also the capacity of the material to be recycled in Australia. Some of the policies where we're looking at is one of the key solutions for managing the contamination suggested during the inquiry is the establishment of glass-only recycling bin for all Victorian households and businesses. There's a clear need for education to what is recyclable and how it needs to be sorted, and the committee has recommended that an education campaign is a priority. One thing comes to mind to make sure that people are putting the waste in the right bins, and we have a single standard colour bin, for example, for recycling, where it's different colour bin exists in various city councils. There was also a substantial discussion about the container deposit scheme, both in the submission and public hearings, and the committee has recommended that the government consider an introduction of CDS. The committee heard about solution to reduce the amount of material also going to landfill, including the landfill increase, which I've covered that, and the committee has recommended the use of energy from waste option in Victoria. And in considering its option, the government should open to a strong public health and environmental regulation need to be put in place. And also there's issue about the committee recommending the government to seriously consider declaring waste as an essential service. Now, I would like to conclude by want to thank all my fellow committee members who come from a range of political parties and philosophical position for the professional, collegiate way of their approach as inquiry from the outset. We had many disagreements, but I think there's a lot of time was put in to make sure we can put together a quality report based on evidence, and I want to thank my fellow committee members for the good work they've done. But also, more importantly, I would like to thank the staff of the committee, in particular committee manager Michael Baker, inquiry officer Kieran Crowe, and research assistant Alice Petrie, These professional staff members have worked long hours and have assisted the committee by managing a significant amount of data and a large number of public hearings and inquiry, and following the report not be as high standard as it is without their skills and dedication on behalf of the committee. I sincerely thank them for their efforts, and I would like to also thank the committee administrative staff, Justine Donoghue, and the rest of the committee secretariats for the administrative work that's been done to the High Senate throughout the inquiry. And finally, I recommend, I hope that the government will seriously look at this report and its recommendation and the expectations, and I hope sincerely that the government will accept the recommendation and the finding of this report. With these few words, I commend the report to the House.